Hi, I'm Darren Gracke, doing case analysis for Lagunitas Brewing Company. Lagunitas was founded in 1992 by Tony McGee in Lagunitas, California. He actually started the company in his kitchen, but in 1993 he was kicked out of his kitchen and had to move to the back of a small grocery store. But by 1994, he was too big for the grocery store and found himself in an 8,500 square foot building. There he put in a 14 barrel brew system and Lagunitas' first ever bottling line. Here's an actual video of Tony himself talking about his company. It's about a 5 minute video talking about the strategies of where his company's going and where it has came from. Lagunitas Brewing Company, through its 18 years, has continued to grow. It now supports a 250-barrel automated brew house that brews over 150,000 barrels annually. And to put that in perspective for you, one barrel equals 31 U.S. gallons of beer, and so that's 4,650,000 gallons of beer that Lagunitas brews every year. Some of the environmental factors that they have to be careful and watch for is that they have a high supply of good quality clean water. That's where the best taste of the beer comes from. If they have poor quality water, they will have poor tasting beer. And then the other thing is getting rid of the wastewater that comes out of the brews. And in 2013 alone, every month Lagunitas was paying over $250,000 a month just to transport and get rid of their wastewater somewhere else in California. Competitive strategy for Lagunitas is accommodate what the buyers want. They always want to brew what the taste of their buyers and just accommodate them. And then also the communities that they're in. They have big community events. Actually, when they moved from one of their storage or one of their buildings to the next, they actually moved across the street. And so they had a big festival. And then at one point during the festival, they blew an air horn and had everybody there just grab something from one warehouse and move it over to the other one. And that's how they moved warehouses at one point. Lagunitas, U.S. beer markets are very attractive, and there's, over the next few years, room for all of them to grow at approximately 0.7%. And so there is growth there. And there's always demand for new brews with what the customers want and what the taste development for a new flavor. Everybody always likes trying a new flavor, and there's ones that catch on and customers really like, and so it can be a success. And then with the new taste palettes of customers, the breweries have to find ways to brew the beers that fulfill the taste of their customers. Some of the standings where they compare. This chart here is from 2012 through 2013. And you can see that Lagunitas was the top craft brewer. But with that, they ranked about sixth on the chart for that year. But looking at it, the fifth place competitor, there was no data for them for 2012. Fourth place, they were only 11,000 barrels behind the fourth place. So really the data could have been skewed for that year, so Lagunitas could have actually been in the top probably four of the craft brewers in the United States. This is fucking and this is the top 50 overall brewing companies. Yes, you can see that Anheuser-Busch is number one, followed by Miller Coors and Pabst Brewing Company, which are your big brewing companies. They do some microbrews now, but not as much. But Lagoon is actually finished in the top 10 at number 9. And so them wanting to take on the big dogs of the beer brewers, they are in competition with them and slowly gaining on them. The SWOT analysis, the strengths for Lagoon is, you know, unique market focus, marketing that beer that everybody likes and continuing to do it, not switching off of it right away. It's privately owned, privately controlled, so they can control their own destiny. Now they've moved into a new brewing location in Chicago. So they have one in Chicago and California, which they now have a larger footprint. And then strong customer loyalty. Being loyal to their customers, brewing what they want, the customers. Weaknesses, they don't have a major marketing like Anheuser-Busch. Never heard of Laguna's brewing company, but so you know the marketing's not out there, and then the low capital with it. The profits and margins are low because they're not Anheuser-Busch, one of the big brewing companies. They have low profit, but now with the larger footprint, that can probably happen. But opening the new brewery, they're gonna have a lower cash reserve just from opening that. Some of the opportunities, you know, they're continuing to support the communities that they're in. When they moved to Chicago, there are other microbreweries out there, and they're outside the city limits. They actually pick a place inside of Chicago so they can be within the people, around the people that are actually buying their product. And then if they increase their marketing and promotion products, getting into those big concert venues, and everything, the festivals, like the other microbreweries. Threats is the large number of competitors. You're always going to have the kitchen, just like Tony, guy starting in his kitchen and opening a brewery and possibly taking over. Suggestions, they need to address possible threats and weaknesses, the, you know, profit and loss, and just making sure they're doing things like they have been in the past, continue to do them. And some of the suggestions I would make, strategically identify a location for the second brewery, which they have. They're opening the one in Chicago. But when they do it, they've got to identify their distribution strategy. They were sending trucks from California clear to Manhattan and everything. Now they have to figure out where they're going to stop sending it both ways, you know, to meet the middle and making sure they're not overlapping their distribution. Keep that focus on that access to the clean water. If they start getting some of the, you know, bad water, they're going to have bad batches of beer, brews, having to dispose of that, and that's going to cut into their profit. And then with the two breweries, making sure they have consistency of the ingredients and the resources to keep their batches the same. So if you get a beer from California, and then for McGee to take on the large breweries, talked about it a little bit ago, they are, as of March of 2017, they are in 9th place, which is pretty good. But they'll have to look for branding of the product that Lagunas is producing and marketing of a new brand or product will also play a major role in this. And so just making sure their marketing, they've got to get stronger in that aspect of their corporation to make sure. And that will help them get a bigger, larger footprint, even in America here. And through expanded marketing and strategic planning, that will help address the cash flow. So, thank you for your time, and for any additional information, you can please contact me at my email, dlgracki@gmail.com.